I'm Kristen.
I'm Mark.
And together we run Kangaroo Valley Pastured Eggs.
About 2.5 hours south of Sydney in beautiful Kangaroo Valley.
People are always asking about what the difference is between free range and pastured eggs. So what you get in our system is it's a constantly moving system. They're outside all the time. Our trailers are never locked up. So the birds, I can get up at 5 a.m. and they're straight out, straight onto the grass. And so it gives them this really interesting, different dynamic lifestyle.
In the same time, we're trying to spread the manure load around the paddock so as we get better grass growth. And so yeah, when they come back around to the same point, there's really good grass coverage.
So that's why we move them so often, so that they're always on a fresh patch, always on fresh grass, always getting something new and something interesting. For us, that's what makes pastured eggs so much better than a normal free range. The birds are so much happier and they have so much more space to move around. We're small.
We started really small.
We started with 50 birds and now we have 8,000, and every chook that we have leads a fantastic life.
I'm Andrew Britton. I'm the Small Landholder Engagement Officer with Local Land Services as part of the Every Big Counts project, and today we're in beautiful Kangaroo Valley. The network's been going since 2004, and one of the joys of the job is actually coming back to farms like this. It's really exciting to see people like Mark and Kristen start off small and seeing the benefit and the business that they've built and the community connections that they've created. It's just a wonderful example of a young couple trying their best and really succeeding in small-scale agriculture.
The biggest thing for me and I think for us in the beginning was that we just wanted to leave it better than we found it. We couldn't have started what we've started without being able to use other people's land.
We don't own the land out there. One's a free lease, one we pay money to lease. And they gave us the worst paddock on their farm, and they were not convinced that what we were doing was going to have any impact. They thought the other paddocks were better. We've changed their worst paddock into their best paddocks.
And that's what we've been working towards for the last few years, is that we want to be able to make our future farming and be able to produce something from the land and just being able to leave it better than we found it.
And you hear a little bit about this in the farming world, people changing their paradigms, and that often happens when some big event has happened in their life. So for Kristen, Kristen had breast cancer in 2017.
That's part of why I wanted to do this. You know, after you go through a life-changing sort of a thing, you want to create a family lifestyle that's different and time to spend with them, and they have such a good time out there. And we're sharing our job and our passion with our kids as well. And I think that that's a really awesome thing for them. And we get so much time in the sun with our feet in the grass, and there's something really special about that.